Exclusive contract from Feilu Novel Network novel. Honghuang. My ancestral dragon, choose the dragon clan to retire at the beginning. Crossing the world of the wilderness and becoming the leader of the dragon clan, Zulong, Shen Long said the pressure is immense. He has a noble status and a profound background, and can become a saint. Nuwa created an artificial human, with profound blessings and the ability to become a saint. If you have thick skin, you can also become a saint. But he is ordinary, what can he rely on to become a saint? Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 10 million and receiving rewards. This is the top-notch innate spiritual treasure, the ancestral dragon ball. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 50 million and receiving rewards. The innate spiritual root is a yellow plum tree. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 100 million and receiving rewards. With the help of Hongmeng Purple Chi. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 1 billion and receiving rewards. Chaos Spirit Treasure Time and Space Wheel. Looking at the countless people around him, Shen Long shamelessly smiled. He never expected that he would become a saint by creating dragons and committing sins. Feilu Novel Network reminds you that this novel and its characters are purely fictional. If there are any similarities, they are purely coincidental and should not be imitated. Chapter 1. Crossing the Ancestral Dragon and Binding the Dragon Making System. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Is that enough to travel? And it's still a desolate world. But why became the ancestor dragon in the Dragon Han Cataclysm? Shen Long sighed in amazement, his mood extremely complicated for a moment. Sanqing comes from a noble background and has great merits. He can learn from Hongjun and become a saint. Nuwa created a human race by kneading clay, helping to perfect the heavenly way. She can learn from Hongjun and become a saint. With extraordinary perseverance and strong aptitude, he comprehends the path of cause and effect, and has opened up 800 other doors. He can learn from Hongjun and become a saint. Although Zhuanti likes to dream foolishly, he dreams to the extreme, with many wishes and wishes. In the end, his dreams come true, and he can learn from Hongjun and become a saint. But what about him? The leader of one of the strongest three tribes in the wilderness, if we talk about it, is probably on par with Hongjun. How can we learn from him? Besides, even if it's apprenticeship, Hongjun still has to take care of it. Is it difficult or not? I, Shen Long, am destined to die in a world of chaos and disaster. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 10 million and receiving rewards. This is the top-notch innate spiritual treasure, the ancestral dragon ball. Just as Shen Long sighed about his tragic fate, the sudden sound of the system prompt made him stunned. Yes, all travelers must have golden fingers, and he is no exception. Quickly getting to know his golden finger, Shen Long was stunned for a moment. Everyone else is a lottery system, a selection system, but to his surprise, it's a dragon-making system. Simply put, the more clan members there are, the more rewards they can receive and the stronger their strength will be. Is it difficult for the system to change its rules based on the inherent lust of the dragon? Forget it, no matter what, it can be considered as having a system. The only goal at the moment is to have lewd development, don't be reckless. Thinking of this, Shen Long refined the ancestral dragon ball in a simple way. This precious treasure was destined for him, so it was quite easy to refine. Then, Shen Long began to arrange for his subordinates to ring the dragon calling bell and summon all the dragon clan powerhouses from the entire infinite four seas to come here. The dragon calling bell is a special treasure of the dragon clan. Whenever it rings, any strong member of the dragon clan will sense it and rush to it. This time, Shen Long summoned these dragon clan powerhouses to announce something important. Time slowly passed, and in the blink of an eye, 100 years had passed, and almost all the strong members of the dragon clan gathered inside the ancestral dragon hall. Zhulong leader, you are the younger brother of dragon ancestor. Do you know why Dragon Ancestor summoned us this time? Yeah, is it difficult to attack the Fong and Qilin clans? Not bad, I think it must be like this. Those two tribes, relying on their alliance, actually seized the territory of our dragon clan and killed our dragon clan's son. It's really audacious. Humph, when Dragon Ancestor orders, we will gather the elite of the dragon clan and completely eliminate those two tribes. For a moment, the entire Zulong Hall was filled with righteous indignation, and many strong members of the dragon clan planned to fight against the Phoenix and Qilin clans. The enmity between the three tribes has been long-standing and cannot be resolved at all. The best solution is to end the war with war and annihilate the other two tribes. But what they don't know is that if it were the original ancestral dragon, they would definitely choose to attack the Fong and Qilin tribes, while now Shen Long only wants to overcome the dragon Han calamity with all his heart. Look, Dragon Ancestor has come out. With a sound coming out, everyone cast their eyes towards the front. On the dragon chair, Shen Long's figure gradually appeared, and with it, the aura exclusive to the dragon clan's hegemony swept across the entire hall. All the dragon clans felt Shen Long's pressure and immediately prostrated themselves on the ground, bowing and bowing to him. We pay our respects to the dragon ancestor and wish the dragon clan a long and boundless life, never to be destroyed. All right, everyone get up. This time, the emperor has summoned you to come just to announce one thing. Shen Long waved his hand, withdrew his pressure, and signaled for many strong members of the dragon clan to stand up. Upon hearing what Shen Long said, everyone's faces showed joy, but they thought Shen Long was going to order an attack on the other two tribes. But soon, Shen Long shattered their illusions. I declare that from now on, no member of the Dragon Clan can leave the Infinite Four Seas unless it is necessary. Otherwise, no wonder I will punish him severely. What? Brother. Dragon Ancestor. Upon hearing Shen Long's words, everyone looked at him incredulously, not understanding what he meant. Brother, our dragon clan is now one of the strongest races in the wilderness. There are over 10 million members of the dragon clan with pure bloodline, and there are countless members with hybrid bloodline. Now let's retreat to the wilderness and not leave the boundless world. Isn't it right to hand over the land to others? Zhu Long looked straight at Shen Long, with a reluctant expression in his eyes. Yes, all the strong members of the Dragon Clan are ambitious, even though the four seas are immeasurable and vast, occupying more than 60% of the land in the wilderness, which is enough for the Dragon Clan to develop countless elemental societies. But there are countless spiritual treasures and resources in the vast land, and it would be difficult for him to accept such a large piece of cake if given to the other two tribes. All right. Let's not say anything more. The emperor's decision on this matter has been made and no one can change it. Speaking, the pressure of Shen Long's quasi-holy cultivation was once again released, and even Zhu Long's younger brother could not resist. In just a moment, he knelt down to the ground. Seeing this scene, Shen Long ignored it and then swore to the heavens, "The heavenly way is above us. I am the leader of the Dragon Clan, Zhu Long. Now that I feel that the heavenly way is incomplete, I am willing to lead the Dragon Clan to suppress the Infinite Four Seas. From then on, I bless the vast land with smooth weather and peace. Anyone who protests will be expelled from the Dragon Clan, their bloodline will be taken back, and I will never recall them. I hope the heavenly way will learn from it." Boom. As Shen Long's words fell, the heavenly Tao shook and the original Dragon Han cataclysm disappeared by a third in an instant. The energy of the Dragon Clan's previously entangled quantity cataclysm slowly dissipated, and at the same time, a huge and unparalleled heavenly Tao merit descended from the sky, heading straight towards the boundless world. Chapter 2. The Dragon Clan exits the wilderness, struggling until the end. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Yujing Mountain. At this moment, Hongjun, who was comprehending the 3,000 paths within the jade plate of creation, suddenly opened his eyes and looked straight towards the direction of the Infinite Four Seas. The dragon clan was originally trapped in a great calamity and had no possibility of escaping, but now they have truly escaped from the quantity calamity and have also obtained the merit of the heavenly way. What is going on? Continuously deducing the situation of the dragon clan, unfortunately, Hongjun did not receive any useful information. With a sigh, Hongjun couldn't help but speak up, "The way of heaven is impermanent. It seems that we need to quickly and thoroughly understand these 3,000 principles." After finishing speaking, Hongjun closed his eyes and the creation jade plate spun again. This time, the power of the law was noticeably stronger than before. But as the heavenly way gradually improved, it also provided more help to Hongjun. After all, Hongjun is the spokesperson appointed by the heavenly way. The stronger the heavenly way, the stronger Hongjun will be. Meanwhile, on the western demon mountain, Luo Ting, who was refining the four swords of Zhu Xian, had an unpleasant expression on his face. He had planned to mobilize the three tribes during the Dragon Han Cataclysm and take the opportunity to kill and prove himself. Unexpectedly, the Dragon Clan withdrew from the competition and handed over the cake to the other two clans. It seems that the leader of the Dragon Clan is also a genius, and he needs to pay more attention. "Humph, your Dragon Clan runs fast, otherwise we'll have to call your Dragon Clan extinct." Luo Ting snorted coldly. He majored in Slaughter Avenue. If the Dragon Clan did not withdraw from the Three Clan War this time, he would join the Dragon Clan in destroying it. But it was obvious that his plan had fallen through, so he could only turn his attention to the Phoenix and Qilin clans. To successfully refine the Zhu Xian formation, he needs billions of essence and blood. In order to prevent any further accidents, he can only accelerate his original plan. "Black Shadow, Poisonous Scorpion, go ahead." Luo Ting let out a low shout, and immediately two black shadows appeared. After bowing to Luo Ting, they disappeared into the darkness. Immediately after, two black shadows flew away from Tianma Mountain, one heading straight towards the southern immortal volcano, and the other straight towards the central land of the wilderness. Besides, inside the Dragon Ancestral Hall. Compared to other dragon clans, the Dragon Clan values the concept of bloodline the most, especially bloodline suppression, which is simply a bug. Shen Long relies solely on his bloodline to control all the strong members of the Dragon Clan, even if these people dare to be angry but dare not speak up. Buzz. The immeasurable merit of the heavenly way descended from the sky and penetrated into the bodies of all members of the Dragon Clan. For a moment, the strength of the entire Dragon Clan greatly increased, and countless members of the mixed-blooded Dragon Clan evolved into purebred bloodlines relying on the power of merit, which once again multiplied the strength of the Dragon Clan. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 20 million and receiving rewards. One of the top 10 innate spiritual roots, Huang Zhongli. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 30 million and receiving rewards. This is the top-notch innate spiritual treasure, the 10,000 Dragon's Plate. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 40 million and receiving rewards. The most valuable measure of merit in the day after tomorrow is the Heavenly Ruler. Quickly, in the blink of an eye, the number of pure-blooded members of the Dragon Clan had reached 40 million. For the Dragon Clan, this is a flying leap. At the same time, the overall strength of the Dragon Clan has also increased significantly, even the great Luo Golden Immortal has increased by hundreds. There is one thing, even if this group of people is strong, they cannot easily leave the boundless world, which makes the Dragon Clan start to feel uneasy. If Shen Long agrees to leave, the entire Honghuang may not become the territory of the Dragon Clan. Accepting his own immeasurable merits, Shen Long transformed into a jade stone and revealed the future development plan of the Dragon Clan to all the strong members of the Dragon Clan. In Shen Long's plan, it is clear that the heavenly way is incomplete and requires continuous use of tribulations to promote development. If the Dragon Clan does not want to exterminate the clan, they must follow his instructions. In addition, the future development of the dragon clan will be to develop every territory in the infinite four seas, and to have more children and trees, increasing the number of pure-blooded tribe members. Otherwise, relying solely on that group of hybrid dragon clans to support the number of dragon clans would be too wasteful. Quickly, a grand meeting was completely over, and Shen Long also announced that the strong members of the dragon clan would return to their territory one after another. With their presence, there will be no more natural disasters such as tsunamis in the boundless world, and even the creatures of floods and wastelands can die fewer. Although it may make these people overuse their talents, Shen Long must do so for the future of the dragon clan. If they don't persist, they will die. As for whether these people will listen to his orders or not, Shen Long expressed that he is not afraid. Since ancient times, people who worship Yin and defy Yang have had no good fate, let alone obtaining a treasure that can punish the dragon clan. Top quality innate spiritual treasure Wand Long Pan. This plate has extremely strong power and can be used to arrange a 10,000 dragons formation, especially with innate restraint ability against the dragon clan. At the same time, this spiritual treasure also complements the dragon clan. For every dragon clan in the 10,000 dragon platter, the power of the 10,000 dragon platter will increase by 1 point. If the entire dragon clan is included, its power may exceed that of the innate treasure. However, Shen Long would not do this either. What he needs to do now is to cover the entire boundless sea with a 10,000 dragon plate. Any evil dragon that commits evil or the dragon clan that intends to invade the vast land and compete for territory will be taken in and never released. Therefore, even if many dragon clans defy Yin and Yang, Shen Long is not afraid at all. Does obedience not develop well in the boundless world? Do we have to join the fun with the Fong and Qilin clans? No longer caring about the development of the dragon clan, Shen Long turned around and returned to his own dragon palace, starting to refine spiritual treasures and choosing to slay the corpse spiritual treasure. Although he has entered the realm of quasi-sainthood, he has not beheaded his body, nor has he comprehended any top-level principles. He relies entirely on his own exploration. It is also for this reason that Shen Long's quasi-holy realm cannot actually fully exert his strength. Otherwise, it won't be so easy when Luo Yan defeats the leaders of the three tribes. Thinking about this matter, Shen Long chose to start seclusion. For a while, the dragon clan stabilized, while the other two clans began to compete for dominance in the wilderness due to the Great War. Chapter 3. Two clans strive for hegemony and perish together, achieving the success of Hongjun. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Due to the withdrawal of the dragon clan, the original three-race competition has become a two-race competition. Driven by the catastrophe, the Fong and Qilin tribes developed rapidly, and soon their members surpassed billions. The last two tribes continued to friction and collide, and finally, under the instigation of Luo Gui, an unprecedented war broke out between the two tribes. The Nanming Lihua of the Phoenix clan is one of the most terrifying flames in the world, and the physical body of the Qilin clan is also incredibly powerful. The two clans are engaged in a great war on the central land. For a moment, all the spiritual treasures emerged, and corpses were scattered everywhere. The strength of countless Phoenix clan and Qilin clan strongmen fell from the sky, and blood turned into a small stream, constantly flowing into the sea of blood. This led to a sudden increase in the cultivation level of the Styx River, which was originally only in the early stage of the Dalai Lama. In just 100 years, it broke through the middle stage of the Dalai Lama. The happiest person about the battle between the Phoenix and Qilin clans is none other than Luo Xian. After all, his immortal slaying formation was only refined by these two clans. In the blink of an eye, 1,000 years have passed, and both the Phoenix and Qilin tribes have suffered losses, with no members remaining. Finally, Luo Ting appeared, intending to slay the Phoenix and Qilin clans in order to prove the Tao. With the appearance of Hongjun, Luo Yi's plan once again fell through. The most intense battle between Tao and Mo unfolded. Although Luo Gui had the four swords of the Immortal Slayer and other ferocious treasures, Hongjun possessed several innate treasures, and there were countless top-quality innate spiritual treasures. After a major war, the central land was destroyed, countless immortal mountains were shattered, and both the Phoenix and Chilin tribes were affected. Helpless, in order to preserve the last trace of bloodline, the Fong clan swore to the Heavenly Way to permanently suppress the volcano, and the Chilin clan swore to permanently suppress the central earth. Only then did they escape a disaster. It seems that the Phoenix and Chilin clans are similar to when Shen Long swore the Heavenly Way, but the results are very different. Shen Long declared the Heavenly Way during the prosperous period of the Dragon Clan, which can be considered as helping the development of the Heavenly Way. Therefore, there are not so many restrictions. Even if the Dragon Clan leaves the boundless sea and enters the wasteland, it is fine. As long as we don't provoke the calamity, the Heavenly Way will turn a blind eye. The Fong and Chilin tribes belong to the category of those who make mistakes and admit their mistakes. If their people dare to appear in large numbers in the wilderness, the Heavenly Way can directly destroy them. Quickly, the oath was over, and the Heavenly Tao responded. The Phoenix and Chilin clans also had an additional layer of prohibition, and their last bloodlines were sent back to their respective ancestral lands, unable to leave easily. On the other hand, the great battle between Hongjun and Luo Gui has also come to an end. After all, Hongjun has the Heavenly Way as the backstage, and no matter how strong Luo Ting is, he still has to lose to Hongjun. After self-destructing thousands of spiritual veins in the West, Luo Ting was seriously injured and was about to die. Before his death, Luo Ting founded the Demon Clan and fiercely disgusted Hongjun, then self-destructed and died. And as a result, Hongjun owed the Western Infinite cause and effect. If the cause and effect cannot be repaid, Hongjun will eventually be unable to reconcile. But fortunately, Luo Yan has died, and everything has come to an end. At the same time, while Hongjun breathed a sigh of relief, Shen Long, who had been watching the battle between Hongjun and Luo Gui in the boundless world, also breathed a sigh of relief. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for exceeding 50 million and receiving rewards. The level of the Ancestral Dragon Palace has been upgraded. Originally, the Ancestral Dragon Palace could control time and accelerate the time flow rate by 10 times. Now, after being improved by the system, the time flow rate has increased to 30 times. This makes Shen Long very happy. Accelerate the process of refining the spiritual treasure in your hand, and thus, the vast land fell back into tranquility. Bai Yin Sango, time flies, in the blink of an eye, thousands of years have passed. Lie tall in the nine clouds, and gather the truth of the Tao. The world is dark and yellow outside, and I should be the leader of the sect. Hangu gave birth to Tai Chi, and the two rituals and four phenomena follow. One path is passed down to three friends, and the two teachings are interpreted and divided. The Xian men are all leading figures, and one Qi transforms into a great force. I am Hongjun. Today, I have attained enlightenment and become a saint. In 1,000 years, I will preach the Great Way at Chaos Zixiao Palace, 33 days away. Anyone who has the chance can come and listen to the way. Buzz. The birth of a saint brings auspiciousness from heaven. Hongjun becomes a saint, while the sage's authority permeates the vast wilderness, a purple aura spanning hundreds of thousands of zhang comes from the east, and waves of immortal sound from the sky. Countless spiritual energy condenses into golden flowers and falls, creating mysterious auras. The golden lotus descended from the sky, rendering the entire wilderness a golden hue, transforming countless creatures and increasing their mana for hundreds of years. Has Hongjun become a saint? Shen Long, who was originally immersed in cultivation, suddenly opened his eyes. Time passed so quickly that he didn't expect Hongjun to become a saint so quickly. However, it's also good. When Hongjun becomes a saint, it will be a witch measuring calamity, and his dragon clan will be safe no matter what. As for whether one needs to leave the boundless world, it only takes one moment. Thinking of this, Shen Long broke through the space and called on Zhu Long and a group of Dragon Clan powerhouses to go to the Purple Sky Palace to listen to the teachings. At the same time, the once silent wilderness began to become lively, and countless innate talents emerged one after another, rushing to the Purple Sky Palace. The first to bear the brunt was the Three Qin Dynasty, followed by a group of powerful figures such as Emperor Juntai, the 12 Ancestors Wu, and Yu Wafushi, the Eastern Prince and Western Queen Mother, and the Yuanzi Kuanpeng Mingyi in Hongyun Town. They are all the first batch of innate beings in the wilderness, with extraordinary strength and opportunities. With their birth, the world of the wilderness officially began to develop at full speed. In chaos. An endless chaotic storm swept over, and the chaotic earth, water, fire, and wind were not to be underestimated. Occasionally, the chaotic raw stones flashed by weighed billions of tons, and ordinary Deluo Jinxian would be seriously injured if touched. If directly hit, even a quasi-saint would not feel good. The reason why chaos is dangerous is precisely because these elements are present. But there is no absolute thing in the world. Although chaos is dangerous, it is nothing to a physically strong cultivator. Among them, the Witch Clan is definitely one of the strongest representatives of physical strength. The 12 ancestral witches are transformed by the essence and blood of Pangu. They are naturally strong and powerful, capable of devouring heaven and earth, manipulating feng shui and lightning, filling the sea and moving mountains, and changing the world. They also control the power of laws. Even if they do not have a primordial spirit, they rarely encounter opponents. At least, there are not many famous powerhouses in the wilderness who are willing to provoke them. Apart from the 12 ancestral witches, the strongest physical beings are undoubtedly the Dragon Clan. The physical strength of the Dragon Clan is no less than that of the 12 ancestors Wu Siheo. Therefore, even when entering chaos, Shen Long did not choose to sacrifice spiritual treasures to protect himself. In this way, under the leadership of Shen Long, the strong members of the Dragon Clan flew for hundreds of years and finally found Zixiao Palace. At this moment, many strong men had already gathered in front of the Zixiao Palace. It seemed that they could rush in as soon as the gate of the Zixiao Palace opened. Squeak! While Shen Long was pondering, the gate of Zixiao Palace opened and Haotian Boy appeared in front of everyone. Dear fellow Taoists, the master is about to start his lecture on the Tao. Please come in quickly. Thank you very much. Shen Long's reaction was the fastest. He didn't even wait for the gate of Zixiao Palace to fully open before rushing in. There are only 6 saintly positions in total. If you slow down one step, you may be taken away by others. When Shen Long was the first to enter the Zixiao Palace, the other strong ones reflected one after another. Sanqing reacted the fastest and then entered the Zixiao Palace. Chapter 4. Shen Long's abdication to the West owes me 3 reasons. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The Zixiao Palace is quite rudimentary, with only 1 high platform and 6 cattails. As for the back, there is a large empty space. Glancing at the 6 buns, Shen Long immediately sat on top of the first one. For a moment, Sanqing followed closely behind and sat next to Shen Long on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th buns. As for the last 2 buns, one was occupied by En Yuwa and the other was occupied by Red Cloud. Hey! It's still one step late. After countless strong men entered the Purple Sky Palace, they all sighed and had no choice but to sit on the ground. As for Shen Long, he is very happy. Anyway, he has secured the position, so there is no need to worry about the lives of others. And just as Shen Long was happy, the system prompt sound rang in his ear again. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 90 million and receiving rewards. This is the top dot quality 8-part floating butcher of the innate spirit treasure. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 100 million and receiving rewards. With the help of Hongmeng Purple Qi. The tribe members broke through 100 million and even rewarded Hongmeng Purple Qi, which surprised Shen Long. At present, he finally managed to grab a position just to obtain Hongmeng Purple Qi. Now that he has Hongmeng Purple Qi, does he still need to apprentice to Hongjun? Once he apprenticed, it was equivalent to owing Hongjun causality, so after thinking for a moment, Shen Long still chose to give up this opportunity. At this moment, Shen Long's remaining light caught a glimpse of Kuanpeng in the corner. Kuanpeng Daoyu, come here. Call me. Kuanpeng stared blankly at Shen Long, somewhat puzzled. He doesn't know Shen Long either. What does Shen Long call him? With a hint of kindness on his face, Shen Long smiled and said, "My ancestor, the dragon, is the leader of the dragon clan, and my fellow Taoist is also a demon clan. We have a connection with my emperor, so why don't I give you this position? What do you think?"
"What?"
Before Kuanpeng could be shocked, Sanqing on the side spoke out first. "There are only 6 seats in Zixiao Palace in total, and Shen Long snatched the first one, but he had to give in. Did he have a broken head? Shen Long doesn't look like a fool, why would he do such a thing?" Unable to understand Shen Long's actions, Tong Tian reminded him, "Friend Dao, the number of seats here is rare, so there might be some great use." "Friend Dao, you just gave up. Do you need to think carefully again?" Tong Tian is also kind-hearted, hoping that Shen Long will not easily give up his position, but Shen Long has already made up his mind, and even if Tong Tian tries to persuade him, there is no way. Of course, letting Shen Long down so easily would definitely not work. What he wants to do is naturally to seek benefits. And just as Shen Long was planning to give way to Kuanpeng, 2 yellow-skinned and sorrowful Taoist priests suddenly appeared outside the Purple Sky Palace. One of them cried and said, "Hey, you and I came all the way from the bitter cold of the West just to listen to the sages preaching. Unexpectedly, we didn't even have a seat. If we just listened to the preaching and went back like this, wouldn't we be laughed to death by Western creatures? Since that's the case, why not crash and die now? Hehe, idiot." The strong members of Zixiao Palace could naturally see that this Taoist was acting, so they didn't pay any attention to him. However, some people were conquered by the acting skills of that Taoist, and yes, this person is Hongyun. Quickly standing up, Hongyun spoke up and said, "Don't cry, Taoist friend. Come and sit with me, I'll give you my seat."
"Thank you very much, Taoist friend. I apologize for your great kindness."
Zhuanti quickly arched his hand towards Hongyun, and there were no more tears on his face. Zhuanti had a position, but there was no lead, which made Zhuanti lose his mind. Coincidentally, Shen Long planned to stand up, which gave Zhuanti an opportunity. "I saw Zhuanti speak up and say, 'This fellow Taoist, my elder brother doesn't have a place to lead yet. Look at you, otherwise it would be convenient for you. Oh, what are the benefits? As long as you are willing to give up a position, my brother and I are willing to agree to your 3 requests, no matter what. Is this statement true?'
"I swear to the heavenly Dao that as long as it's not a request that makes things difficult for both of us, we can both agree."
"Okay, I agree." Shen Long nodded, the effect of receiving guidance and lifting is much greater than that of Kuanpeng. Since Zhuanti can make a heavy promise, he has no reason not to agree. Moreover, Jane Zhuanti is a heavenly saint. If he were to give up his position to someone else, and in the end, Hongjun forcibly changed his position, wouldn't it be a great loss? Therefore, it is better to give it to the receiving and guiding authorities, so that when they become holy in the future, they should not kneel and lick themselves. As Shen Long stood up, Jane also had a position, but Kuanpeng's face at this moment was already ugly. Surprisingly, the position he had originally obtained flew away and slipped away in front of him, which made Kuanpeng resent the fact that he was on the receiving end. Meanwhile, along with Hongyun, Kuanpeng also held a grudge against him. If it weren't for Hongyun giving way, how could such a mistake have occurred? If there was a chance in the future, he would definitely give Hongyun a blood-like price. Time passed quickly, and after waiting for a while, Hongjun's figure quietly appeared in front of everyone. After all,
He is a saint, and Hongjun's aura emanates, making it impossible for everyone in Zixiao Palace to look up at him directly.
Hmm.
Hongjun glanced at the seat below the futuan, and for some reason, his brow furrowed tightly. After a moment, Hongjun glanced at Shen Long's direction and seemed to see something, but he didn't say much.
After this time, your position cannot be changed again, the sermon begins.
Speaking, Hongjun waved his sleeve and the gate of Zixiao Palace closed, followed by waves of sweeping Taoist music spreading throughout the entire Zixiao Palace. And just as Hongjun was speaking on the road, Shen Long quietly took out a stone from his sleeve. This treasure is called the audio-visual stone, which consists of three pieces in total. It has no attack or defense power, but it can perfectly record everything you see. To put it simply, it is a modern version of the video recorder, but it is a VR version that was originally useless when obtained. Now, it seems to have come in handy. As long as we record Hongjun's preaching and show it to the disciples of the Dragon Clan, wouldn't it be possible to significantly enhance the strength of the Dragon Clan? Even if he had a quasi-holy cultivation, he could preach, but Shen Long did not think he could be compared to Hongjun. After all, he is the spokesperson of the Heavenly Way. Apart from anything else, Hongjun's ability to preach is still very good. In this way, 3,000 years passed in a blink of an eye under Hongjun's infamous Sanskrit sound. Shen Long also opened his eyes at the moment when Hongjun stopped preaching, and then quietly put away the audio-visual stone. Chapter 5. The head of the male immortal has a huge influence, not surrounding the mountains. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The sermon is over, and I have one more thing to announce this time. After everyone in the Purple Night Palace opened their eyes, Hongjun spoke again. As Hongjun spoke, everyone's faces turned ugly. Yes, they are immersed in the main road and suddenly awakened, which must be very uncomfortable. After all, not everyone has broken through the realm of Dalai Lama and achieved quasi-sainthood. Looking around the entire Purple Night Palace, apart from Hongjun, there was only Shen Long, a quasi-saint who was still a half-hearted quasi-saint cultivator who had not beheaded his body. Respectfully follow the instructions of Dao Zu Fun. Everyone responded in unison, full of respect. From Hongjun's lecture just now, they already knew how strong Hongjun was, so they naturally dared not disobey him. Nodding his head, Hongjun said in a deep voice, "At present, the Heavenly Way is not complete, and the development of the flood and famine still requires someone to lead. The East Prince and the West Queen Mother, come forward together. The Eastern Prince has seen the Taoist ancestor. The Queen Mother of the West has seen the Taoist ancestor." Upon hearing the call of Hongjun, the Eastern Prince and the Western Queen quickly approached him and bowed, feeling extremely nervous. Looking at them like this, Shen Long knew in his heart that he was afraid it was Hongjun who was going to be crowned as the head of the male and female immortals. Sure enough, as expected by Shen Long, Hongjun raised his hand and waved it, and the two treasures instantly appeared in the hands of the East Prince and the West Queen Mother. "From now on, you two will each be the heads of the male and female immortals, acting on behalf of heaven to punish and control the flood and wilderness. The poor will not leave, and you two should be respected. This treasure is the top-quality innate spiritual treasure, the dragon head staff and the phoenix hairpin, which will be given to you two for self-defense."
"What?
The head of male and female immortals? Daozu, we must never do anything wrong. What virtues do the Eastern Prince and the Western Queen Mother have? How can they control the flood and wilderness? We would like to express our gratitude to the Taoist ancestor. May the Taoist ancestor live endlessly and never be destroyed." Before the sound of dissuasion could be heard, the Eastern Prince and the Western Queen quickly knelt down and bowed, responding. Watching this scene, Shen Long couldn't help but shudder. The head of male and female immortals, it should be noted that besides the quasi-saint, even the great Luo Golden Immortal is also an immortal. It can be said that besides him, all the strong figures in the Purple Lantern Palace, including the three cleans, must obey the orders of the East Prince and the West Queen Mother. This position must be said to be very important. It remains to be debated whether the two of them can withstand it. No need to say more. I have made up my mind, so please leave quickly. 3,000 years later, Zixiao Palace will start preaching again. After speaking, Hongjun waved his sleeve and disappeared, leaving only a group of strong and powerful people with an embarrassed expression, all of whom were not doing anything good. On the other hand, when it comes to the Eastern Prince, he may feel as proud as he is at this moment. Little did he know that the position of the head of the Male Immortal is truly a hot potato, without matching strength. How can he handle it? Not wanting to see the current state of the Eastern Prince, everyone in the Purple Sky Palace left one after another and headed straight back to the wasteland. Among them, the 12 ancestral witches were the most indifferent. Yes, they are not immortals, and there is no division of cultivation levels, so the Eastern Prince cannot control them at all. In their view, the Eastern Prince is well behaved. If he is not well behaved, they don't mind giving him some color to see. The world of the wilderness, not the mountains. At this moment, there is a rainbow glow constantly nurturing within the Buzhou Mountain, with spiritual energy surging, causing the wind and clouds on the mountain to change, and the Dao luck to permeate. At first glance, anyone can know that this is a sign that a spiritual treasure is about to be born. Coincidentally, a group of strong individuals have just returned to the wilderness. With such good news, they naturally bear the brunt and fly straight to Mount Buzhou. Similarly, Shen Long was also among this kind of strong person. When he saw the colorful light, he was taken aback, but he already knew what treasure it was. One of the top 10 innate spiritual roots, the 7 treasures of Gourd Vine. Looking at all the innate spiritual roots, it is probably the highest quality innate spiritual treasures condensed by the 7 treasures Gourd Vine. Now that he has encountered them, Shen Long certainly did not miss the truth. Continuously breaking through the space, Shen Long quickly arrived at Buzhou Mountain with a group of dragon clans, but by this time, many strong individuals had already gathered here. Strong figures such as San Qing, Emperor Jun Taiyi, Eastern Prince and Western Queen Mother, Kuanpin of the Styx River, Jian Zhuandi, Enyu Wafushi, and Zhenyuanzi Hongyun all stationed here to guard. Everyone was hostile towards each other, afraid that the other would take the lead and snatch the spiritual treasure. Seeing this scene, a faint and imperceptible smile appeared at the corner of Shen Long's mouth, but he had already found a way. Ladies and gentlemen, as the saying goes, those who have a chance to obtain spiritual treasures will receive them first come first served. My brothers and I will be the first to come here, and I will also take one of the gourds from each of them. Do you have any objections? Hehe, I'm joking with you. Just now, you killed many creatures. If we follow what you said, should we give them the treasure gourd first? Bold. Bold. Taiyi just gave a cold snort and stopped working at the beginning of the year. The two of them had just finished listening to Hongjun's lecture and were also fired by him, their strength skyrocketed. Now that they have been provoked by too much, how can they swallow their anger? San Qing, don't think that if others are afraid of you, then I am also afraid of you. Let me tell you, whoever snatches the Ling Bao will be counted. If you want to rely on the large number of people to gain power, you may have to ask me if I agree or not, said Taiyi in a cold voice. Not bad. Your words make sense, we agree. For a moment, Taiyi received support from everyone, and one by one, in order to obtain Baohulu, they all expressed their opposition to San Qing. Only Shen Long and the Dragon Clan were standing in the corner, not knowing what they were planning. Okay, since that's the case, then let's all rely on our abilities and take action, fellow Taoists. Laozi was the first to offer sacrifices to the Xianhuang Linglong Pagoda of Heaven and Earth, without paying any attention to his current situation, and directly threw it at Taiyi. Similarly, Taiyi remained invincible. The innate treasure chaos clock hung above his head, and the dark yellow little clock kept spinning and spinning. The power of time and space intersected, easily blocking Laozi's surprise attack. The chaos bell is a treasure that integrates attack and defense. Even the Xuanhuan Linglong Pagoda of Heaven and Earth, which is a treasure of postnatal merit, cannot break through the defense of the Chaos Bell. Therefore, even if Laozi and Taiyi make every effort, they cannot do anything to each other for a while. Accompanied by Laozi's prolonged battle, the scene also began a melee. At the beginning, Emperor Tong Tian fought against Emperor Jun, Kuanpeng, and Mingyi, while the Eastern Prince and Western Queen Mother fought against Enyuwa and Fuxi. They then led Zhuanti to fight against Zhenyuanzi Hongyun for some unknown reason. Only Shen Long was there, because he had been silent and no one paid attention to them. Hehe, it's interesting. Then you guys take your time fighting, and I'll take the Lingbao away. With a murmur in his heart, Shen Long's backhand changed and a pitch-black grinding wool depicting tens of thousands of five-clawed golden dragons appeared in his hand. P.S. Seeking flowers and evaluation tickets are all very useful for the author. I hope everyone supports them. Chapter 6. Seven Treasures of Gourd Vine Slaying Corpse, Mighty Warriors in the Flood and Wilderness. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Top quality innate spiritual treasure, Wan Long Pan. In the past, Shen Long, in order to prevent members of the Dragon Clan from disobeying orders and leaving the Wuyang Four Seas without authorization, causing a great calamity, deliberately left a backup in the Wuyang Four Seas. Shen Long shrouded the entire Infinite Four Seas in the 10,000 Dragon Plate for countless years. During this period, over a million dragon clans left without authorization to enter the wasteland, but were all included in the 10,000 Dragon Plate. Over the years, the power of the 10,000 Dragon's Plate has long surpassed the average level of top-notch innate spiritual treasures. Even if it collides with Taiyi's Chaos Clock, it has nothing to do with it. Originally, Shen Long did not expect to retrieve this treasure, but after all, Hongjun's preaching had begun and the Lich Demon Realm was brewing. For the time being, the Dragon Clan was considered safe, so retrieving it was not a big deal. Go. Shen Long raised his hand and threw it, enveloping the entire Buzhou Mountain with a 10,000 dragon plate. In an instant, countless five-clawed golden dragons flew out of the 10,000 dragon plate and began to attack indiscriminately, causing the chaotic battlefield to once again become chaotic. At first, everyone just wanted to test each other's strength, but as they fought, they became truly angry and didn't hesitate to take action. Taking advantage of this opportunity, Shen Long quickly walked towards the seven treasure gourd vine, pondering how to collect all the gourds. He is not a fool either. Looking at the entire Buzhou Mountain, he is the only quasi-saint. If we don't take advantage of the present to collect more spiritual treasures, won't he lose his advantage when other strong players step into the quasi-saint? But before Shen Long could approach the seven treasure gourd vine, San Qing was the first to notice Shen Long's actions. How dare you stand up? Stop it now. With a loud shout from San Qing, everyone turned their gaze to Shen Long, but Shen Long's violation of rules caused public anger. Feeling the almost cohesive gaze of everyone, Shen Long quickened his pace and didn't care if they would join forces to attack him. After all, he has been practicing for countless years before this group of people, and he has countless magical powers behind him. Moreover, he has 10,000 dragon plates to help him, so protecting himself is not a problem. On the contrary, it's them. If they really act rashly, don't blame him for being ruthless. As fellow Taoists have just mentioned, those who have a chance to obtain Lingbao will receive it, and our emperor has a chance to obtain Baohulu, so we will take it first. Thank you very much for your love. Shen Long arrived at the Seven Treasure Gourd Vine and was about to pick up the gourd and the Chaos Bell hit Shen Long. At the same time, the mysterious and exquisite pagoda of heaven and earth, the dragon head staff, the phoenix hairpin, the seven precious trees, bitter bamboo, and earth books all arrived one after another. Even Shen Long was prepared at this time, and under the bombardment of these spiritual treasures, his blood and energy rolled, and a trace of blood spilled from the corner of his mouth. It seems that everyone is really ruthless. Shen Long originally didn't want to provoke any public anger, but since these people are so ruthless, don't blame him for being ruthless in his actions. As the words fell, Shen Long separated a strand of primordial spirit and directly penetrated the seven treasure gourd vine. For a moment, the seven treasure gourd vine shone brightly, and a man dressed in green appeared in front of Shen Long. He looks the same as Shen Long, except for his different clothes and his friendly manner. But there were seven precious gourds on top of his head, which were exactly the seven precious gourds nurtured by Bu Joshan just now. What is the situation? Everyone present was shocked and looked at each other with a puzzled expression, but they didn't understand what was going on. At present, Hongjun's preaching has not fully grasped the path of sanctity, so they are unaware of the matter of beheading three corpses to prove the truth. Now Shen Long is the first to behead the body, which has broadened their horizons and made them unable to understand the scene before them. I, the Seven Treasures Taoist, have met my true self. Huh, you're welcome, Taoist. We are one and don't need to be polite. Shen Long bowed back and said with a smile. He was still hesitating about using some spiritual treasure to slay the corpse before, but now it seems that there is no need to hesitate. The Seven Treasures Gourd Vine is one of the top 10 innate spiritual roots, with extraordinary feat and levels. Looking at the entire wilderness, apart from the innate treasure, there is no spiritual treasure that can be compared to it. In addition, there are seven precious treasures nurtured on the Seven Treasures Gourd Vine. If it can be fully cultivated, it may advance the spiritual treasure and become an innate treasure. Therefore, no matter how you look at it, using the Seven Treasure Gourd Vine to chop the corpse is the right choice. Buzz. A blue light flashed through, and the Seven Treasures Taoist infiltrated Shen Long's body, merging with him. The pressure that belonged exclusively to the quasi-holy realm erupted, causing many strong figures present to sink their bodies and unable to directly look at Shen Long. The realm of a sage. Is it difficult for him to become a saint? Impossible, his aura is much weaker than that of the Taoist, he must not be a saint. Is it difficult to become a saint and still have a realm below it? Why didn't the Taoist master talk about it? This person's cultivation has been greatly improved, and we cannot be enemies with him. For a moment, the hearts of the people on Mount Buzhou became complicated. Now that Shen Long's cultivation was much stronger than theirs, if we really started fighting, not only would we not gain any benefits, but there was also a possibility of completely offending Shen Long. If they were to be resented by Shen Long for this, they were afraid they would not escape, so many people began to beat the drum of retreat. The first to retreat were naturally Zhen Yuanzi and Hongjun. At first, they just joined in the fun and snatched the spiritual treasure with a trial mentality. Now that the Lingbao has been taken away by Shen Long alone, it's useless for them to stay here. Glancing at Shen Long, Zhen Yuanzi arched his hand and said, "We admire the friendly methods of Dao. Since Lingbao already has a master, we should also leave. You can do it yourself, Taoist friend." Shen Long nodded, not obstructing Zhen Yuanzi. Seeing Shen Long agreeing to leave, Zhen Yuanzi quickly pulled Red Cloud and flew straight to Wuzhuang Temple. It's better to leave this place of right and wrong early. Perhaps due to a ripple effect, after Zhen Yuanzi Hongjun left, Kuanpeng Mingyi chose to bid farewell one after another. Similarly, Shen Long did not intervene. So, one strong person after another left, and in the end, only Sanqing and Jiayin were allowed to stay at Buzhaoshan. Chapter 7. Taking the Green Lotus Seed from the Creation and Throwing the Candle Dragon. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The reason why Sanqing did not choose to leave was because he felt that there was still a chance waiting, so he did not leave. As for the acceptance of admission, I wanted to see if Shen Long needed any help from them, so that I could repay the cause and effect of the debt owed to Shen Long earlier. But after watching for a while, Shen Long didn't even ask for help from them, which made Jiayin Zhuanti quite frustrated. Do the three Taoist friends still want to compete with our emperor for spiritual treasures? Shen Long's gaze was fixed on Sanqing, and with his current strength, he could easily crush Sanqing with one enemy and three opponents. So, Shen Long is not afraid that Sanqing will continue to trouble him. Shaking his head, Tong Tian spoke up and said, "Zulong Daoist friend misunderstood. Since Lingbao already has a master, we won't compete with Daoist friends anymore. It's just that my three brothers still have a chance here, so we haven't left." Upon hearing Tong Tian's words, Shen Long nodded, thinking that the 24th grade of the Qinglian from the creation was about to be born, so Sanqing did not leave. And Shen Long couldn't snatch this precious treasure. After all, the 24th grade Qinglian will transform into three top-notch innate spiritual treasures, which will also be the spiritual treasures of Sanqing's future enlightenment. It is indeed not destined for him. However, it's still possible to join in the fun. Shen Long nodded and then stopped speaking. Not long after, at the mountainside of Buzhou, a mysterious and mysterious aura of creation emanated. The spiritual energy surged, and the precious light rained in the sky. Then, the 24th grade of creation Green Lotus slowly emerged, heading straight towards the arrival of Sanqing. Seeing this scene, Jian Zhuanti couldn't help but show a greedy expression on his face, but he was very moved. But relying solely on the two of them to snatch the treasure from Sanqing's hands is nothing but a pipe dream. Therefore, taking the lead was just a thought and did not take action. Quickly, Sanqing seemed to have a sense in her heart. She raised her hand and pointed towards the 24th grade azure lotus, then spoke up, "Red flowers, white lotus roots, green lotus leaves." Buzz. Three rays of light shot out from Sanqing's body, followed by the gradual decomposition of the 24th grade Qinglian into three spiritual treasures. One is a coiled dragon pole. A piece of three treasure jade as desired. One piece is the Qinping sword. Taking away the three spiritual treasures, a satisfied smile appeared on Sanqing's face. Then Sanqing bid farewell to Shen Long and left Buzhaoshan. Similarly, after Sanqing left, Jian Zhuanti no longer stayed and bowed to Shen Long before returning to Mount Sumi in the west. Looking at Sanqing in the figure of Zhuanti leaving, Zhu Long stepped forward. "Big brother, now that we have the Ling Bao, should we also leave?" Zhu Long asked. Shaking his head, Shen Long smiled slightly and said, "It's not urgent for now. Look over there." As he spoke, Shen Long's internal magic burst out, and a lotus seed quickly popped out of the place where the 24th grade green lotus was originally born. It is the Qinglian lotus seeds nurtured by the 24th grade of the Qinglian culture. This lotus seed has a high level of quality, and once it can be cultivated, at the very least, it can produce an extra top-quality innate spiritual treasure. Sanqing was not aware of the lotus seed incident, so he was in a hurry to leave. Otherwise, this treasure might not have reached Shen Long yet. In his heart, Shen Long sighed at the benefits of being familiar with the plot. He held the Qinglian lotus seed in his hand and then took back the 10,000 dragon's plate, indicating that he could return to the infinite world. Bai Yin Sango, time flies, in the blink of an eye, 1,000 years have passed. During this millennium, the dragon tribe adhered to the concept of having more children and multiple trees, and the bloodline members of the purebred dragon tribe expanded once again. Not to mention anything else, the ability of the dragon tribe to have children is really strong. Even if a child has only a 1 in 10 chance of giving birth to a purebred dragon bloodline, it has caused a significant increase in the dragon population. If it weren't for the vastness of the four seas, I'm afraid we wouldn't be able to conceive so many members of the dragon clan. In addition, a major event occurred within the dragon clan. It's about Zhu Long getting married and giving birth to 9 sons. As the saying goes, dragons give birth to 9 sons, each one is different. The 9 sons born to candle dragons perfectly verified this statement. The eldest prisoner of cattle, the second Jixi, the third Bayan, the fourth Lion, the fifth Glutton, the sixth Jiaodu, the seventh Bishi, the eighth Qi Kiss, and the ninth Pishio. These 9 sons, apart from anything else, look like nothing but dragons. Each of them has extraordinary abilities and can easily slay dragons, but they have nothing to do with the appearance of dragons. Even though their bloodline is pure, there is still a hint of hybrid bloodline, which makes these 9 mutated dragons extremely special. Perhaps only by giving up can one have something, and it is also because they are mutated dragons that their divine abilities are stronger. At least, Shen Long doesn't care about this matter. On the contrary, it was Zhu Long himself who was very angry. He was a pure member of the dragon clan, and besides Shen Long, he was the only one in the entire dragon clan. How could he be so useless? Since that's the case, we can only leave the matter of continuing the future bloodline of the dragon clan to Shen Long. Steadily starting to look for beautiful women for Shen Long, Zhu Long has also put in a lot of effort. But now Shen Long is busy practicing, so he doesn't have the time to take care of Zhu Long. With the success of Shen Long's dismemberment, the appearance of the 7 treasures Taoist can be said to have helped Shen Long solve many difficulties. At the same time, the strength has also increased significantly. Regardless of anything else, even Shen Long was a bit afraid of the power of the 7 precious gourds of the 7 treasures Taoist. If anyone really doesn't have eyes and confronts the 7 treasures Taoist, Shen Long expresses silence for them. Inside the Zulong Hall. Big brother, I don't know what you're up to about getting married. The 2 fairies, Shi and Changshi from Taiyin Star, Enyuwa Fairy from Buzhou Mountain, and West Queen Mother Fairy from West Kunlun are all famous fairies. They are all beautiful like flowers, but they can be worthy of Big Brother. Zhu Long earnestly advised Shen Long, attempting to make him choose one. Of course, it would be best if Shen Long could select all. Others may not know the strength of the Dragon Clan, but as the second in command of the Dragon Clan, Zhu Long is very clear. If it weren't for Shen Long's refusal to let the Dragon Clan's army leave the Infinite Four Seas, the Dragon Clan might have been able to lead the vast wilderness in just a few minutes. In addition, Shen Long is also too double standard, causing members of the Dragon Clan to sacrifice their lives to have children, but he has never been close to a woman himself. Isn't this a scene? Anyway, whatever he said this time, he wanted to find a fairy for Shen Long. But at this moment, Shen Long didn't listen to what Zhu Long said. The Dragon Clan is developing so fast now, and the system prompt sound in his ear is also constantly ringing. Chapter 8. The tribe breaks over 200 million, the land of floods and wilderness 3. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 110 million and receiving rewards, the 8 treasures merit pool. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 120 million and receiving rewards. Chaos 9 transformation scripture. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 130 million and receiving rewards, Qianquan Ding. Ding, congratulations to the host tribe for breaking through 200 million and receiving rewards, the origin of spatial laws. The members of the purebred dragon clan's bloodline have reached 200 million, and Shen Long has also received incredibly generous rewards. Not to mention anything else, the rewards of the Chaos 9 Transformations Manual and the Origin of Space Laws alone have been immensely helpful to Shen Long. The Chaos 9 Transformations Manual is derived from the 9 transformations of ancestral dragons, which can enhance the bloodline of the dragon clan and enhance the power of the physical body and elemental gods. In terms of single round level, it has surpassed the 9 transformations Xiangong inherited by Sanqing. Also, because the Chaos 9 Transformations Manual is highly compatible with the Dragon Clan, every time it reaches one transformation, Shen Long's magic and physical body will double. When practicing to the 9th transformation, even the innate treasure cannot harm Shen Long. Replacing the original practice of the 9 transformations of the Ancestral Dragon, Shen Long began to operate his Chaos 9 Transformations Manual with satisfaction. At the beginning of its operation, Shen Long could feel the changes in his breathing of spiritual energy, with a difference of 10 times. If he practiced for another 10,000 years, his strength would probably increase dramatically. As for the origin of spatial laws, this is a good thing that can make Shen Long instantly understand spatial laws. As the saying goes, time is king and space is revered. Looking at the entire wilderness, only Emperor Jiang is skilled in spatial rules, and because his spatial rules are sufficiently bug-free, he can become the leader of the 12 ancestral witches. Now Shen Long has also mastered the laws of space, and once it is unleashed, it will definitely surprise the creatures of Honghuang. However, this is considered a hidden tactic, and unless absolutely necessary, Shen Long will not easily reveal it.
Big brother, why haven't you reacted after all I've said? Is it possible that you can't even look up to these people?
Zhu Long shouted Shen Long twice, his face full of confusion.
These female immortals are among the top figures in the wilderness. If Shen Long still doesn't like them, he has no choice.
If the ancestral dragon bloodline cannot be inherited as a result, then it can only be blamed on Shen Long himself, not others. After regaining his senses, Shen Long laughed and replied, "Don't worry, wise brother. This matter requires marriage, but I'm not in a hurry. On the contrary, I've had a great opportunity recently. You can pass it on."
Speaking, Shen Long passed on the reduced version of the Chaos 9 Transformations Manual to Zhu Long.
Feeling the inheritance of the martial arts in his mind, Zhu Long first immersed himself for a moment, then said with great joy, "Big brother, with this martial arts, our dragon clan can completely dominate the wilderness. No one can match it. Wu Wei has him because the Chaos 9 Transformation Scripture is really terrifying. Who can surpass the dragon clan if they can stack and enhance their physical and spiritual cultivation methods to a high level? The reason why the witch clan is powerful is because of their strong physical bodies. The reason why the demon race is powerful is because of its large number. The dragon clan now occupies these two innate advantages, and it is unreasonable not to dominate the wilderness."
But soon, Shen Long poured another basin of cold water on Zhu Long.
"My dear brother, why do you always think of dominating the wilderness? Let me ask you, what benefits do you have after dominating the wilderness?"
"This. Seize resources and develop ethnic groups.
What about after that?"
"It's gone. It's gone. Why can't we seize resources and develop our ethnic group in the infinite four seas? Do you think our dragon tribe has already occupied all of the infinite four seas?"
Shen Long sternly asked.
Pangu was already a sage of the half-step avenue, and the vast and boundless world he opened up was unimaginable. The Wuliang four seas occupy 70% of the land in the wilderness. Not to mention now, even with the development of 10 elemental guilds, the dragon clan may not be able to completely occupy every ocean in the Wuliang four seas.
Zhu Long sat in the well and watched the sky without understanding these things, but Shen Long understood them.
Therefore, he must make Zhu Long clearly aware of this.
"Yes, the boundless world is incredibly vast, and our dragon clan has only occupied nearly one-tenth of it in the past 10,000 years. We still need to continue to develop."
A word startled the dreamer, and the candle dragon instantly woke up.
Then he nodded, indicating that he understood.
Seeing Zhu Long seeming to understand his own meaning, Shen Long said again, "At present, the most important thing for our dragon clan is to cultivate pure bloodline. As for those dragon clans with mixed bloodline, if there are those who have committed many evil deeds and are entangled in karma, they can directly enter the evil dragon abyss."
"It's big brother." Zhu Long responded, and he also understood what to do next.
As for the evil dragon abyss, it was a top-grade innate spiritual treasure obtained by Shen Long before, which formed a world of its own and only imprisoned the dragon clan with karmic entanglement. When all his karma is washed away, he can leave the evil dragon abyss, which can be considered one of the ways for Shen Long to establish his authority in the dragon clan. At the same time, as the dragon clan continued to create dragons, the vast land was also constantly changing. The first to bear the brunt is naturally the Eastern Prince, the head of the Male Immortal. In response to the call of Emperor Daozu, the Eastern Prince summoned Male Immortals from all over the world to form an Immortal Court, intending to command the vast wilderness. Countless Male Immortals have defected to the title of the head of the Eastern Prince's Male Immortals, gradually expanding the power of the Eastern Prince. On the other hand, Emperor Jun Tai,
because of his arrogance and being the emperor of the demon clan, summoned all the demon clans in the world. All members of the demon clan must join the demon clan power formed by the two of them, and for a while, they began to compete with the immortal court. Others may care about the title of the head of the Eastern Prince's male immortal, but Emperor Jun doesn't care at all. It is expected that the two brothers would be born with precious protection and pure bloodline. In addition, there is another major force that must be mentioned. It's the Witch Clan. Since the opening of the Panga Palace, the Witch Clan has been constantly producing people for some reason. The number of great witches has reached nearly 100,000 in just 100 years, with countless small witches and ordinary witch warriors. Although the number of witches is the lowest among the three major powers, their strength is not inferior to the other two. After all, the witches are naturally strong and capable of moving mountains and filling the sea, holding the sun and moon in their hands. When facing the Witch Clan, even the immortal court of the Eastern Prince has a lot of headaches. The most crucial thing is that once the members of the Witch Clan are about to be killed, they will choose to self-destruct. Even if they die, they will have to pull the enemy into the water, which is the most headache-inducing point. Chapter 9. Everyone confesses to power, East Prince wants to fight. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Kunlun Mountain, inside Sanxin Cave. Big Brother, currently there is a tripartite conflict in the chaos. I wonder which side we need to support. Yuanchur looked at Laozi and asked for help. The current flood and famine are quite complex, with numerous forces, and it is impossible for Sanxin to be self-sufficient. Once those three tribes turn their attention to these scattered cultivators, they will inevitably fall into a passive position. Instead of doing so, it is better to choose a good camp as soon as possible, which can also cope with unexpected needs. Upon hearing Yuan Shi's words, he snorted coldly all day, a group of clowns jumping off the beam. Do you want me to join Sanxin? If they really dare to come knocking on me, I don't mind competing with them. Third brother, you're too serious. Although my three brothers have good strength, they are still weak. As brothers, how about getting along well with the immortal court? I thought for a moment and replied in a loud voice. Upon hearing Laozi's words, Yuan Shi thought for a moment and agreed. Anyway, Dong Wang Gong can also be considered as the head of male immortals appointed by Hongjun Daozu, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with being good at Dong Wang Bus. If Daozu were to be introduced in the end, I believe Daozu would also help the Eastern Prince. Thinking of this, the three of me summed it up again. Although they had no intention of joining in, they were willing to make friends with the Immortal Court. Therefore, I even sent a boy to convey their intentions. When he learned that Sanxin had taken the initiative to show goodwill, the East Prince's confidence was shattered. He was overjoyed for a moment, but he did not lose his pride. Instead, he was willing to accept Sanxin's goodwill and expressed his willingness to protect Sanxin as long as he did not oppose him. After conveying the message to Sanxin, Emperor Jun Taiyai also received the support of Kuanpeng and Yuhua and Fuxi. They are all members of the demon tribe. Although their power is impressive, like Sanxin, they are all weak and weak. Now that the world is in a state of tripartite confrontation, they should prepare early. As for the final witch race, no one is willing to intervene, and no one dares to intervene. The Wu ethnic group values blood and identity, and generally seeks refuge through casual cultivation, either being driven away or insulting. Either it's left as food for the development of the ethnic group, which is cruel enough. The vast land of the East is in full swing, with constant struggles, but in contrast to the West, there is nothing happening and everything is quiet. It's also true that the West has been extremely impoverished since Luo Ting self-destructed thousands of spiritual veins. It can be said that even mice are willing to survive in the West, so naturally no one will go to the West to compete for territory. Looking at the barren and uninhabited land of the West, I couldn't help but feel embarrassed. However, soon a ray of faith appeared in the hearts of the two, believing that with their efforts, the West would eventually recover its former glory. Time has passed again, and another 1,000 years have passed. As the saying goes, there is no time in the cave, and in the blink of an eye, it has been 1,000 years. Time in the vast world is the least valuable. In the blink of an eye, 1,000 years will pass. In this millennium, the friction between the lich and demon tribes has been the most intense, but the one with the most casualties is the immortal court. There is nothing else, just because the immortal court is the strongest and has the greatest influence. Although there have been small-scale battles between the lich and demon tribes, there has never been a truly fierce battle. On the other hand, when the two tribes deal with the immortal court, they always make every effort, which makes the Eastern Prince extremely angry. Within the Immortal Court. Report to the Eastern Prince, the two tribes of witches and demons have once again united, and our Immortal Court has suffered heavy losses. Bold and unrestrained, my friend Donghuang Gongdao, these two tribes of witches and demons are truly audacious and must be severely punished. Not bad, it's been 1,000 years now and they haven't even taken us seriously. This time, we will personally take action and teach them a lesson. As their subordinates reported, a group of powerful individuals in the wilderness were extremely angry. They had already chosen to defect to the Immortal Court, so naturally they wanted to focus on the Immortal Court. How can the lich and demon tribes tolerate this shame as they continue to launch attacks on the Immortal Court? The chill on his face was clearly visible, and the Eastern Prince waved his hand and said, "Don't worry, fellow Taoists. Although the lich and demon tribes should be destroyed, we should not be afraid. As long as we give our all, we can destroy them in minutes. Now, I have a great opportunity and plan to share it with fellow Taoists. What do you think?" "Donghuang Gongdao's friend, but it doesn't matter what you say. Okay, as fellow Taoists know, I was born with a ray of yang energy. Through inheritance, I learned about the existence of the overseas three immortal islands, all of which were transformed into chaotic original stones. There are countless spiritual treasures and abundant resources on them. If we can find these three immortal islands, it will definitely increase the strength of our immortal court. Therefore," unexpectedly, is what Donghuang Gongdao's friend said true. "Nature, there is no exaggeration at all." Donghuang nodded. He had a connection with Penglai Immortal Island and naturally wouldn't lie. Everything he said was also true. After a moment of contemplation, someone spoke up and said, "This matter can be considered confidential. Your ability to inform us is truly broad-mindedness. We admire it, but... hey, it's just something, mother.in.law. Speak up if you have anything." "Yeah, my friends from the Eastern Prince have all informed me of these secrets. What else can't I say?" "Not bad, speak quickly." "However, as far as I know, the three immortal islands overseas are located in the boundless four seas. Once we step into the boundless four seas without authorization, what should we do to provoke the Dragon Clan?" The scattered person of the five elements hesitated for a moment, as he still had a great fear of the Dragon Clan. Especially in the past, Shen Long took action and fought against many strong opponents. If Shen Long were to be angered, wouldn't they be unable to bear it? "Humph, the Five Elements Dao friend is really cowardly. What if the Ancestral Dragon tries to grab it again? He's not a shrunken turtle who dares not easily leave the boundless world. What are we afraid of?" "That's right, and besides, our immortal court strength is increasing day by day. Even if Zulong faces us, he should obediently admit his cowardice and not be afraid." "I agree. Now, except for the lich and demon races, any force in front of our immortal court is nothing and nothing to mention." For a moment, the entire immortal courtyard was filled with arrogance, not only fearing Shen Long, but also expressing that Shen Long was not to be feared. Upon hearing these people's discussions, the Eastern Prince couldn't help but secretly shudder. He is more aware of Shen Long's strength than these people. If he fights alone, he is afraid that Shen Long can become the first person under the sage. It's really bad to provoke him. But he must seize the three immortal islands overseas, otherwise he will not be able to quickly enhance the power of the immortal court, nor can he quickly annex the two lich and demon tribes. Therefore, the eastern prince said in a low voice, you Taoist friends don't need to argue. The dragon clan has its own king to deal with it. You just need to find a way to find the Three Immortals Island overseas. Seeking flowers, seeking evaluations, seeking rewards, seeking monthly tickets, I hope everyone can support me. Thank you. Chapter 10. Candle Dragon PK East Prince, Shen Long quickly kills big. You are listening at novelfull.audio. The power of the Immortal Court was mobilized, instantly arousing the ideas of countless powerful people in the wilderness. But what surprised this group of people was that the East Prince did not reach out to them, but instead turned his hand and went to the infinite four seas. What is this for? Is it difficult for them to subdue the Dragon Clan? For a moment, there were constant speculations about the fate of the Eastern Prince, and no one was certain of his intentions. Only Shen Long knew the purpose of the Eastern Prince in the moment when the immortal power appeared in the boundless world. Want to find the Three Immortals Island? Have you ever asked me about the Dragon Clan? Shen Long sneered and looked down upon the actions of the Eastern Prince. Although the Dragon Clan does not compete with any power, it does not mean that the Dragon Clan is afraid of things. On the contrary, the Dragon Clan is belligerent and has extremely strong combat abilities. The Immortal Court has come from all corners of the world to search for the Three Immortals Island, without even asking him. What is this? Throughout, Shen Long has been suppressing the Dragon Clan and preventing them from engaging in excessive fighting. Now that the people of the Immortal Court have taken the initiative to bring them to your door, we cannot blame the Dragon Clan for their ruthless actions. Accompanied by Shen Long's command, the entire boundless sea immediately began to churn. All disciples of the Dragon Clan gather in groups of three, and anyone who dares to invade the Dragon Clan's territory will be killed one after another. And, they will also seize the Lingbao to enhance their own strength. In just 3 years, the number of people in the Immortal Court continued to decrease. Originally, there were 50 million scattered immortals sent out, but after 3 years, there were only 20 million left. And those 30 million were all killed by the Dragon Clan. The shore of the East China Sea is a fertile land. Penglai Immortal Island appeared faintly, but the emperor did not disappoint the diligent people, finally allowing the Eastern Prince to find the location of Penglai Immortal Island. But don't forget, Penglai Immortal Island is located on the boundless sea and belongs to the territory of the Dragon Clan. Now, the East Prince wants to seize Penglai Immortal Island without saying a word. How could the Dragon Clan agree? Therefore, under the leadership of Zhu Long, the Dragon Clan faced off against the Immortal Court power of the Eastern Prince. Dong Wang Gong, this is our Dragon Clan territory. Please retreat quickly, otherwise, no wonder my subordinates are ruthless. Zhu Long's huge dragon eyes looked at the Eastern Prince, and his tone was irrefutable. It was evident that Zhu Long was really angry at this moment. Faced with the angry candle dragon, the Eastern Prince was not afraid, but sneered, the remnants of the Dragon Han Cataclysm. Candle Dragon, do you think your Dragon Clan can dominate the Wasteland? Now that the Wasteland is under the control of our Immortal Court, if you pick it up, obediently give up Penglai Immortal Island. Otherwise, we will inevitably slaughter the Dragon Clan. Ha ha ha, joke, it's such a big joke. East Prince, do you really think I don't know about the chaos? You can't even do anything about the witches and demons, you want to blood wash the Dragon Clan. Come on, I'll see how you blood wash it. Humph, stop using your tongue and tongue, Dragon Head Staff, go. The Eastern Prince refused to talk nonsense to the Candle Dragon and directly threw his Dragon Head Staff to attack the Candle Dragon. Similarly, Zhu Long remained invincible, spitting out his ancestral dragon pearl and engaging in a fierce battle with the Eastern Prince. The ancestral dragon ball was temporarily given by Shen Long to the Candle Dragon. The Candle Dragon has extraordinary bloodline, but it has not yet reached the level of the Great Luo. It will take some more time to cultivate. Coincidentally, the ancestral dragon ball can enhance the strength of the candle dragon, so Shen Long temporarily gave it to him. Anyway, it's not a dragon pill. For Shen Long, this thing is just a magic weapon. Bang! The ancestral dragon ball and dragon head wand collided continuously, causing the sea to roll and dark clouds to cover. The entire coast of the East China Sea was washed away again and again under the tumultuous tsunami. Thanks to the absence of any living creatures on it, otherwise, the power of this tsunami alone would be enough to take away their lives. Seeing that he couldn't do anything about the candle dragon for a while, the East Prince's face darkened and he silently recited a few words. In an instant, the dragon head staff shone brightly, and the authority of Hongjun Daozu swept out. This is a treasure discovered by the Duke of the East by chance, which can release a trace of Hongjun's power and suppress the enemy. I originally intended it as a killing move, but unfortunately, in order to make a quick decision, the Eastern Prince still used it on the candle dragon. Break it. The Eastern Prince took out a flying sword and directly penetrated the huge body of the candle dragon. However, with just one sword, the candle dragon suffered significant injuries. That flying sword is one of the original spiritual treasures of the Eastern Prince, with a high level. Coupled with its ability to attack the candle dragon without any resistance, it can easily break through the defense of the candle dragon. That is to say, the candle dragon's body is strong and powerful, otherwise, this sword candle dragon would suffer serious injuries. Hehe, candle dragon Taoist friend, I have already advised you. You must not listen. Currently, billions of years of cultivation are about to crumble. I see what you should do. After speaking, the Eastern Prince raised his dragon head staff and smashed it towards the candle dragon. Bang! The dragon head staff directly hit a precious gourd, instantly flipping back, and the aftershock's power also made the East Prince's blood boil and feel very uncomfortable. Looking in the direction of the treasure gourd flying towards him, when Shen Long appeared, the East Prince's face froze and he became cautious. Dongwon Gongdao's friend is a bit too domineering. Aren't we members of the Dragon Clan? Someone you can harm as you please. Shen Long's light swept towards the Eastern Prince, causing him to sweat profusely. Humph, Zulong, today our immortal court will inevitably occupy Pinglai Immortal Island. If you give it, you have to give it, if you don't give it, you have to give it. On the side, the Qinmu Taoist pointed at Shen Long, looking as if he was about to kill him if he didn't obey orders. With a cold smile, Shen Long's palm grew several times larger. Without waiting for Qinmu Daoist to react, his palm penetrated the space and grabbed Qinmu Daoist's head directly. Dao Yu subordinates. Bang! Before the words of the Eastern Prince could be spoken, the Qinmu Taoist was instantly killed by Shen Long. You should know that Qinmu Daoren is a cultivator in the middle of the Dalao period, and under Shen Long's command, he has no room for resistance. How can one believe this? Even the powerful in the wilderness are unwilling to believe what is happening in front of them at this moment. Since Shen Long's strength is so strong, why did he choose to withdraw from the wilderness in the first place? Is it difficult or not? Is there any secret or difficulty involved? For a moment, the entire flood began to speculate, all wanting to know some of the mysteries of the Longhan Cataclysm back then. Unclear about the thoughts of the sentient beings in the wilderness, Shen Long turned his gaze once again to the Eastern Prince. Dongwon Gongdao friend, I am not an unreasonable person. As long as you can provide reasonable compensation to satisfy my Dragon Clan children, I can allow you to leave, otherwise. Shen Long's words fell, and in an instant, six precious gourds soared into the sky. These six precious gourds are exactly the companion spiritual treasures carried by the Seven Treasures Taoist. Currently, they are fully urged by Shen Long and can instantly unleash their power beyond all else. I dare not say anything else, at least the people of the Immortal Court like the East Prince are still capable of killing in seconds. This hesitated as he looked around at the constantly floating gourds, and the Eastern Prince hesitated. Shen Long's strength is too strong for him to confront. If he admits now, he can still avoid losses. If he doesn't admit it, even if he kills himself, no one will help him report to the Taoist ancestor. Instead of that, why don't he bow down first and then go to the Taoist ancestor's place to participate in Shen Long's book, and seek revenge from him?
Ha ha ha, Sulong Daoyu laughed.
Our immortal court and the dragon clan are good friends. How could we possibly hurt our harmony because of this? Just now, I was just fighting with Zhulong Daoyu, and I never expected to hurt him. I still need compensation. After speaking, the Eastern Prince took out an object from his arms and threw it toward Shen Long. Seeking flowers, seeking evaluations, seeking rewards, seeking monthly tickets, I hope everyone can support me.
Thank you.